Hey dudes, my name's Blekoh, and what's this on my head? Well, it's a VR headset. Whoa! Pretty neat, huh? Recently, I picked up one of these bad boys from the internets, which I've been playing a few VR games over the past few weeks, and it's been pretty neat. You know what else would be pretty neat?
My mom!
Is if I made my own VR game. So that's what I did.
This is the Metaverse! It's the Metaverse! That is the Metaverse 2! I'm Mark Zuckerberg, and this is the Metaverse! I am the Metaverse! Now, I'm an NFT in the Metaverse! I'm Mark Zuckerberg while being in the Metaverse!
Alright, so now that that's out of the way, I want to make a VR game. So where exactly should I start? Well, to make a VR game, like any game, I need a game idea. But it needs to have gameplay that'd be feasible in a VR world. Also, because I'm just a single developer, I want to limit the scope so that it doesn't take me forever to make, since 3D models can take up a lot of time. Okay, so game idea. Well, I'm thinking about making a small little game, maybe an MMORPG, something like World of Warcraft. I don't know if you've heard of it. Ha! Just kidding. Back in the day, every game developer forum always had people asking how to make some massive game, like it was some simple thing that could be answered in one forum post. But the truth is, games take a long time to make, even simple ones. So for this project, I want to limit the scope, because I want to be able to finish this in a reasonable amount of time.
Have you finished those errands?
So with that in mind, what should I make? Well, back in 2014, I started on a game project for what I thought would be a fairly simple game. Basically, you wake up in a pod where you've been in cryo sleep state for an extremely long amount of time. And when you wake up, your pod is really far underground because the planet you're on is being terraformed, or something along those lines. The gameplay for the game essentially revolved around managing your energy, how much you could carry, and what tools you were using to dig your way through to try to eventually make it to the surface, and of course survive any mutated creatures along the way. I'm definitely going to change story-related elements, but I feel like this sort of game would fit pretty well in VR. Also, because of the nature of being underground, I can limit the amount of assets I need to make so that it's more feasible for me to actually complete the game. Even though I had a start to the project, where I had modeled a few things in Blender and made a dirt digging mechanic, it was a pretty old non-VR Unity project, which I'm surprised still runs. And maybe it would have been somewhat okay for an indie game back in 2014 if I'd continued along with what I had, but I definitely want to go for something that looks much more modern. So setting up a VR project in Godot is pretty simple, thanks to this guy. He basically wrote the plugin and a pretty sweet VR toolset by himself. So I started a new project and plopped in the necessary camera setup for running my VR headset. It only takes a few minutes, and you instantly have a way to run your game on your VR headset with controller tracking. Then using the toolset, you can easily add movement, which it supports both the more motion sickness prone smooth movement, as well as a teleporting movement, which is pretty heckin' sweet with how easy it is to set this up. I've already spent the time to write out exactly how I want this game to look, the story, and the gameplay for it, so I wanted to basically implement at least what I already had in the old Unity project, but better. I went ahead and started building up my starting pod room to at least get the basic feel for how it's all gonna look in VR. I started with building out the floor, then setting up some walls, and getting the ceiling in place. Which all of these panels have static bodies associated with them, so they'll just work with the VR player physics automatically. With the starting room built out, I added in the placeholder hand models from the VR toolset, which I'll replace those later with something more fitting. With a basic player controller and the starting room structure, the next thing to implement was some kind of digging system with dirt. This has been the hardest part so far. The first approach I went with was going with a voxel engine plugin. I thought it'd work pretty well for what I was doing, and this plugin even supports smooth voxels instead of Minecraft-looking blocks. It has a couple demos, even one that is very similar to Minecraft. So if you want to build something similar to that, I'd definitely recommend checking it out, since it seemed pretty simple to use. Unfortunately, I found that it really doesn't work well if I'm trying to generate a bunch of voxels around structures that are underground. Also, I think there might be some bugs, because sometimes the terrains I generate seem to get corrupted, and then they basically just don't work at all, even when I remesh them. I mean, this could totally just be my inexperience with the plugin, but I decided that it wasn't for me to use on this project. So what do you do when there isn't a great solution to what you're trying to do that's already made? Well, you just write it yourself. So I wrote my own block management system that can dynamically subdivide itself so I could have really small blocks or big blocks, while also being pretty efficient. The downside is that they're still blocks, and this isn't Minecraft. So I might revisit this later, but after playing with it in VR, I think having a detailed environment but blocky dirt is okay, since I tried the smooth voxel system, and it seemed kind of frustrating to tell where your digging is happening. Alright, digging. So I also implemented a digging system, which for now, my tool just looks like a cylinder, but I'll soup that up later on, so I can use my magic cylinder to dig out blocks from my block system. It doesn't look pretty right now, but I'll update the materials and add particles and whatnot later. So yeah, that's basically where I'm at right now. I can walk around in my VR game and dig into my dirt blocks, which might not seem like a whole lot, but it's actually a huge start on this game, so I'm pretty excited with what I've done so far. There's definitely still a long way to go though, so I'll see you dudes in the next one.